Hi, I'm Hanbit, and I'm a pastry chef from Korea. Today, I'll be showing you how to make hazelnut praline. Praline is a type of nut paste, but it's a bit more than that. It's caramelized nut paste, and that's what makes it so good. And you can buy it off the shelf, but I recommend you to make them because it tastes so much better, and it's much cheaper that way as well. Today, I'll be using hazelnut to make the praline. And other than hazelnut, you can use any types of nuts. So you can use pistachios, almonds, hazelnuts, and anything you want. But I prefer hazelnut above anything else because of that amazing aroma that hazelnut has. And when you turn it into a paste, it's just amazing. And where is it used? It's used variously across pastry products. You can put it on cookies, you can put it in tarts, you can put it, it definitely goes into patty breast. And so it has very many different uses. So please, you know, don't buy them, just make them yourself. So before we start, we need to process the hazelnuts. When I say process them, it means roasting them. I need to roast these hazelnuts because by roasting them, you can bring up all the nutty flavor. And that's essential because it affects the end product. So how do you toast it? I'm going to put it in the oven at around 160 degrees or so for about 8 to 10 minutes. Right, so we now have the toasted hazelnuts. And what we need to do now is we are going to melt the sugar and turn it into a caramel. And then we're going to add in the toasted hazelnuts. Right, what you need to remember while melting sugar here is that there are two different types of caramel. And what we're doing today is dry caramel because you don't have any water. The other type of caramel is wet caramel where you add a bit of water. I prefer the dry caramel because it's faster and it's much more convenient because you don't have that water component in it. If you want to find out more about the dry caramel, just please click the link above. So I'm going to add in the sugar. Right, sugar's gone in. I'm going to heat it up and melt the sugar. Just make sure that you melt the sugar evenly and you can stir it or just shake it up. Right, you can see the sugar melting. Now I'm going to get my spatula and stir it. And once you see that the sugar has melted completely and it's light brown, I'm going to add in the hazelnut and stir with it and coat it completely with melted sugar. Right, I'm going to add in my hazelnut. Once that hazelnut goes in, the hazelnut is extremely cold in the view of the caramel. So you will see that it stiffens up and the caramel will simply solidify. You will get these lumps. But keep stirring and you can break it into pieces. The whole point of this is that you are evenly coating the hazelnut with caramel. And the better you coat it, the better your hazelnut praline will taste. Have you clicked like and subscribe? I mean, that looks amazing already. Right, doesn't that look amazing? You know, it just looks amazing, and of course it tastes amazing. Now I'm putting this on a silicone mat, and I'm going to leave it to cool completely. Just spread it so that it cools faster. Right, so my caramelized hazelnut has completely cooled. Now I'm going to break it into pieces and put it into my food processor. Just make sure you get one of these food processors. They are absolutely amazing to have with. You can do anything. They're like a genie's lamp. So I'm going to grind it. I'm going to grind it into a paste. Before it turns into a paste, it turns into powder. Just scrape the sides off once in a while. Well, this powdered caramelized hazelnut won't turn into paste. They'll stay as powder. Oh, wow. Look at that. That has turned into paste. That's what a paste looks like. It's completely turned into a paste, a spread. Look at this. Mm. What's amazing about hazelnut praline is that it's dominantly hazelnut. And you have that hazelnut aroma just coming up like that. But you also have that scent of caramel behind. So that's hazelnut praline done. And please make it at home. It's not difficult. You can do this. And you can store it for weeks. Although as time goes on, you lose that hazelnut aroma. But for the first week or two, you know, it just stays there and you can store it for an extended period. So you don't have to make it every day or so. Please click like and subscribe if this video was useful, and I'll come back with black sesame praline in the next video. Thank you very much. 감사합니다.